Enter to win a new surf skate every month at surfskate.love/giveaway. I found this Kahuna Creations Shaka longboard on eBay for a great deal. It's only 46 inches long, and I typically am not interested in anything shorter than 50 inches. But what intrigues me about this one is the extreme rocker profile, which is that downward curve you see. I'm very curious to see how that rides. And these are actually intended to be used with a land paddle. But you know I don't roll like that, so I'm going to put a waterborne surf and rail adapter on this and take it to a whole new level. And through the month of September 2024, you can enter to win this Shaka longboard with waterborne surf and rail adapters and SurfSkate Love wheels. Enter to win now at surfskate.love/giveaway. So for this build, I'm going to use a waterborne surf adapter with reverse kingpin trucks. And I've already processed these because I've used these before. We're going to use Riptide bushings. These are 87.5A Riptide bushings in both our rail adapter and that I've replaced in these RKPs. And I also have already replaced the surf adapter bushing in here with a 97.5A. The stock bushing comes with 95A, and that just stiffens it up for me at my weight and rides a little bit better for me. So we've got our waterborne surf and rail adapters all ready to go. We just need to install them. And then, of course, I'm going to use SurfSkate Love wheels in 70mm 78A and my favorite bearings, G-Bomb bearings. So we'll start by removing these longboard trucks, and I'm not going to use these because these trucks are so wide and I like trucks that are a lot narrower. The waterborne trucks come with hangers that are 8.5 inches wide, so you can see that's a lot narrower there, and that's going to ride a lot better. It'll be a lot less prone to wheel bite as well. So personally, I never use these wide longboard trucks because they just don't work well on surf adapters. Okay, so now let's install our rail adapter, and I've found that it's a lot easier to take this apart and install it on the deck. Let me show you how we're going to do that. I'll just take a ratchet wrench here. And this will pull apart. And we've got a set of washers and bearings on top. And then we've got this set inside there as well. And I just use this little screwdriver to fish these out. But there's our bearings. And that's that Riptide bushing that I said I replaced. And so now we'll just install this top base plate onto our deck here. So with the top base plate installed, now we can put the other piece on. Put our bearings in place first. And here's our other set of washers and bearings, followed by our nut. Get that to where it's just snug and there's no play, but we want to make sure that that's not too tight, because if that's too tight, we're going to damage our bearings and it's just not going to swing freely. So I'm going to back that up just a touch, and that should do it for our surf adapter. And now we'll do the same thing for the rail adapter. We're going to just take it apart here, and then we'll just install it one piece at a time. Now we put on our barrel bushings, followed by the top piece of our rail adapter with pivot cups facing out. followed by our cone bushings on top. And there's our rail adapter. And there we have it. This thing is ready to ride. Let's go take her out and see how this rocker feels. Quick note before I show you a ride is I took this out on a ride before we filmed, and I realized that this rocker actually changes the angle of the surf adapter, which means that it didn't ride very well at all. So what I did is I took it back and I put a wedge riser on it. So I have de-wedged this to now compensate for that rocker. You've got that rocker profile that comes down, and I put a 5-degree wedge riser there. And so now I haven't ridden this yet, and so now we'll test ride this with the de-wedged riser to compensate for that rocker.